was found not guilty on was the one involving Rahm Emanuel and allegedly shaking him down for some sort of project that they wanted. He was found not guilty on that, but he's going to go away for a long, long time. And yes, there is another twist and turn in the Casey Anthony murder trial. We'll perhaps get to that if we can. But first, let's bring in our friend Jeff Miller. Jeff Miller is a young man that you guys met about a week or so ago. He is a senior at Centennial High School, and he is suffering with diabetes and went back, along with a number of other students, to D.C. to, among other things, meet Mary Tyler Moore, but also to address Congress in terms of juvenile diabetes research and the Juvenile Diabetes Research Foundation. And he joins us, the returning conquering hero. Jeff, how was our nation's capital?
Oh, it was great. Thanks for having me today.
Well, first, let's get what really everybody wants to know, particularly me. What was it like meeting Mary Tyler Moore?
Well, actually, she was sick. She had a surgery, so we did not get to meet her. She was unable to make it this year.
Really?
Some last-second changes.
Oh, that's too bad.
But it was still great. We had a great time there.
Yeah, walk us through your trip. You get there on what day?
I actually arrived on early Sunday morning. We took a red-eye flight out of Bakersfield on Saturday night.
Okay, what'd you do all Sunday morning, Sunday afternoon?
Basically, my dad and I just... Children's Congress wasn't going on at the time. It didn't start till Monday.
Right.
So we just slept and caught up on some needed sleep.
Yeah. You didn't run around D.C. at all?
No, we came back, we ate, we slept, and then later we actually watched a movie.
Okay, very good. Very good. And then the Congress began that following Monday.
Yep.
Well, walk us through that.
So basically the following Monday, we officially checked in the hotel, and basically all of the delegates were staying in the same hotel, so it was really fun, conversing with them and really getting to know them.
What hotel was it?
Is the JW Marriott. It's
nice.
Actually very close to the White House.
Yes, I'm familiar with it. That's a nice hotel.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead. So you're checking in and you're, hello, I'm Jeff Miller from Bakersfield, how are you? Fast forward us to going before the committee.
Well, before the committee, that was actually the very last thing that we did. And not all of us participated in the committee, but they did pick three delegates to present speeches in front of the committee. And they talked about their struggles with diabetes and other important things relating to the disease. And they were asked several questions by the committee. And it was very interesting listening to them.
Yeah, yeah. What was the consensus in terms of the problems they have with type 1 diabetes?
Well, basically, it was really interesting, seeing how other people react to diabetes besides myself.
Right.
And a lot of the people, have trouble, especially the younger ones. And there's actually an older girl who went on a trial for the artificial pancreas, which is what we were really pushing in D.C. while we were there. And it was really interesting hearing from her.
Yeah. Explain what the artificial pancreas is all about and how that helps diabetes.
Well, basically right now we have what's called an insulin pump, which gives us insulin. It's kind of like an IV in our body, and it gives us insulin to control our blood sugar. Well, we still have to prick our fingers or arms, as I do, several times a day. And with the artificial pancreas, you actually have a blood glucose sensor inserted into your body so that you don't have to prick yourself.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a closed-loop loop system. The sensor that's on your body communicates with your pump, and they decide between the readings what they need to do for your blood sugar.
Wow. Now, I thought that the new pump, the new insulin pump, saved you from having to prick yourself.
No, actually, it doesn't. They don't have that approved yet.
Wow, I did not know that.
Yeah, but actually, several other countries have this artificial pancreas approved. Some of them are France and Canada. But the FDA is really slowing it down, so that's one of the real things that really... big things we were pushing is the artificial pancreas, because it will actually save a lot of money.
Yeah, yeah. What else went on?
Well, while we were there, we spoke to the congressmen, and that was really interesting. I got to speak with Mr. McCarthy, and that was great. And we also got to speak with our senators, which we got to speak to the aides of the senators. They were a little busy for us.
Typical.
And we also sang, the theme of our trip was Promise to Remember Me, and so we actually sang with Crystal Bowersox, who's a type 1 diabetic.
Wow, didn't know that.
She finished second on American Idol one year, and she has a very amazing voice.
Yeah. Wow.
He sang in front of the Capitol with her, and it was televised, and, you know, we really got out our message to the public that way.
Well, good for you. Sounds like a wonderful trip. How long were you there?
Monday, well, actually, I just got back today because we extended it into a family vacation afterwards.
Yeah, good for you. What sights did you see? What were you most impressed with at our nation's capital?
I personally really like the Washington Monument. I think it's a really cool building, and it's a great view at the top. If you ever get a chance to do that, you know, go to the top, especially during the night. It's just a wonderful, beautiful view.
Wow.
And I was really impressed with a lot of things. I thought it was very beautiful, but that definitely stood out to me.
Did it bring everything that you've learned to life, so to speak?
Yes, you know, in the history books, I always get to see pictures of the Capitol and the Washington Monument and so forth, but actually getting to see it was a different experience, and it was really great.
Yeah, that's good. Jeff Miller is our guest. Jeff is a young man suffering with type 1 diabetes. He is a Centennial High School student who is active in sports and was just part of the Children's Congress back in Washington last week with another of 150 kids. Other than the artificial pancreas, where would you like to see the money go? What would best help you and people like you?
Well, basically just really putting the money into trials to develop new alternative things besides the artificial pancreas to help diabetics, you know, take the load off of them so that they don't have as much trouble keeping control.
So the monitoring of the insulin is by far the biggest obstacle.
Yes, and really, the artificial pancreas is the biggest thing we have right now. It's our biggest hope besides the cure, because it really takes a load off the diabetics so that they don't have to worry as much.
Yeah, yeah. Well, good for you. I'm excited for you, man. Where, you're graduating this year?
Yes, next year I'm going to graduate.
Yeah, where are you going to school?
I'm really not sure yet. I'm hoping maybe I can go to somewhere down south in California. We actually got to tour the Naval Academy while we were on the East Coast, which was really cool.
Yeah.
But other than that, I haven't really looked at any schools on the East Coast or outside of California for that matter. UCLA would be a dream school for me.
You ever thought of Morehouse College?
Sorry?
You ever thought of Morehouse College?
Nope.
No? All right. It's a black school in Atlanta. I'm just saying.
Oh, okay.
It's where I went. You know, I'm just saying.
Okay.
My producer says you want to be an endocrinologist. Tell our listeners what that is exactly.
Well, basically, I've decided I kind of want to be an endocrinologist because you can specialize in the diabetes aspect of it, and what you can do is you can treat other diabetics, and I think that would be really easy for me to relate to, and so it would be a great job for me.
And it would be great for your patients who, you know, when you're telling them to do this and do that, and you don't know what it's like, doc. Oh, yes, I do. I'm a diabetic.
Exactly.
Good for you, Jeff. Nice job, man. Way to represent us. And keep us abreast of what's going on. If there are any other things, let us know. We'll get you back on the program.
All right. Thank you very much for having me.
All right, man. Have a good senior year.
Okay.
Take care, buddy. Jeff Miller, everybody. Love that kid.